"That will suit me," asserted the Ork with a groan. "Oh, my feet are hurting me dreadfully, and for the last few miles I've been limping with pain."
"My foot hurts, too," said the sailor, looking for a smooth place on the rocky floor to sit down.
"Your foot!" cried the Ork. "Why, you've only one to hurt you, while I have four. So I suffer four times as much as you possibly can. Here, hold the candle while I look at the bottoms of my claws. I declare," he said, examining them by the flickering light, "there are bunches of pain all over them."
"Perhaps," said Trot, who was very glad to sit down beside her companions, "you've got corns."
"Corns? Nonsense! Orks never have corns," protested the creature, rubbing its sore feet tenderly. "Then maybe they're what do you call 'em, Cap'n Bill? Something about Pilgrim's Progress, you know."
"Bunions," said Cap'n Bill.
"Oh, yes, maybe you've got bunions."
"It's possible," moaned the Ork. "But whatever they are, another day of such walking on them would drive me crazy."
"I'm sure they'll feel better by morning," said Cap'n Bill encouragingly. "Go to sleep and try to forget your sore feet."
The Ork cast a reproachful look at the sailor man, who didn't see it. Then the creature asked plaintively,
"Do we eat now, or do we starve?"
"There's only half a biscuit left for you," answered Cap'n Bill. "No one knows how long we'll have to stay in this dark tunnel where there's nothing whatever to eat, so I advise you to save that morsel of food till later."
"Give it to me now," demanded the Ork. "If I'm going to starve, I'll do it all at once, not by degrees."